Good morning, Shaun. Dave from Greatland Gold's with me this morning. Shaun, how are you?
Yeah, really well, thanks, Andrew. Thanks for having me this morning, and good to connect again.
A couple of days back, this exploration update on Havieron published, reporting some of the most significant results of the project outside of the South East Crescent zone. Bring us up to date here, Shaun.
Yeah, look, thanks, Andrew. I think the best result in that is that intercept 104, which is this plus 6 gram intercept over 60 meters. What's most interesting about that is the location. So it's 200 meters to the south of the existing Eastern Breccia. So that's a huge potential expansion of that Eastern Breccia structure, but also the grade, it's more reminiscent of what we're seeing in the South East Crescent. And it sits kind of to the north of that South East Crescent. So it opens up, you know, large avenues for exploration or new zonations, which could be a continuation of that high grade Southeast Crescent, which would be, you know, tremendous, but equally a higher grade structure into that Eastern Breccia and coming a lot further to the south. So really we're spoilt for choice there, but it's a really interesting intercept. And as part of, you know, what, there are 33 intercepts, 22 of them in, you know, significant high-grade mineralization. So again, Havieron just keeps delivering. The more you drill this, the more value you create, the more mineralization you identify.
So you're now drilling 250 meters below the resource estimate, are you?
Yeah, so this is back into to the Southeast Crescent proper. So, you know, that's a main area. That's the focus of the pre-feasibility study, where we'll be doing that starter mine and really trying to mine out plus 5 gram material, which will generate strong free cash flow for us from, you know, immediately as we go and move into production. What's nice about these intercepts is we've done some infill drilling, which continues to firm up that area for the initial mining. But then as we've stepped down, we're now 250 meters below that resource, continuing to get these, you know, 5-6 gram plus average intercepts, which really gives you a bit of a flavour that we'll be able to continue to walk up and move up that the resource and reserve around that area over time with more drilling and more study. So that's a tremendous intercept, and that's the backbone of this mine.
What about some of these targets outside of the Havieron system, Havieron North and Zipper?
Yeah, look, what's interesting right now is we're increasing the activity across the mining lease. So, of course, Havieron proper continues to be a huge focus for our drilling campaign. But what we're doing now is identifying some of the other targets that we have, both high gravity and high magnetic targets on that mining lease itself. There's no place better to look for gold and copper than where it's already been found. So, you know, it's a good place to look. And also we've got this dolerite structure, and we're walking up along there and seeing some really interesting mineralization or structures along there, which is not initially where we're going to focus, but some of the initial hits we've had there suggest there's this structural moving quite far out from Havieron, which again talks to the opportunity for additional discoveries or just a much bigger Havieron system. So yeah, we're really pleased with how that initial drilling's going.
And what about construction activities? How's all that going?
Yeah, construction's doing well. Look, it's multifaceted in terms of getting the infrastructure at surface and in parallel with that doing the feasibility study. But I think there's a lot of focus always on the decline. We've got about 277 metres as of the date of this report in change, so kind of length of that decline. That's very positive. You're seeing that starting to accelerate. We probably think we've got another, you know, 40, 50 metres in this top area, which is the softest and slowest part of the progress. As we get deeper there, the ground conditions get harder, which actually accelerates you up because your cuts can be bigger, less ground support, which allows you to accelerate. So you know, we've done a lot of the hard work there. We continue to punch that forward, but it is pleasing the way it's progressing, albeit a little bit slow through that earlier area. We have continued to do a lot of geotech drilling, and I think we have the pathway or the route that we think will accelerate this from here.
Shaun, this option here for Newcrest to buy an additional 5% of Havieron from Greatland, what's the timetable around that?
Yeah, thanks, Andrew. The Newcrest started that process with us back in towards the very end of December 2021. You know, potentially that can be resolved as early as February. That's if we have commercial agreement between the two parties. That is Greatland's preference. I think it's always good with a joint venture partner to be able to kind of come to agreement on these terms. So we'll continue to kind of talk to them around that. Or alternatively, if that can't be achieved within the time frame, it goes into this an independent arbitration process, if you will. That's a much longer process. I'm kind of optimistic we might be able to come to agreement with Newcrest in the short term. But as far as Greatland's concerned, we've got to prepare for both scenarios. So equally a more drawn out process, which brings in a number of independent valuations.
Mm. Well, with 8 rigs operational at Havieron currently, what's the vision, what's the focus for Greatland for the project this year?
Look, the focus continues to be, it's a big year for us. The focus continues to be that exploration that you spoke about, particularly that 50,000 metre growth drilling program, together with a lot of infill drilling, and you've seen some infill drilling again in this exploration update. That all positions us really well for a bigger and better feasibility study in the back half of this year. You know, I do like the quote from Newcrest CEO Sandeep, you know, the numbers only get better from here. So I think that's really positive. In parallel with that, Greatland is speaking to a number of banks, got some really positive interest from the banking market. So we'd like to be in a position where, you know, we're effectively fully funded, we have the feasibility study, and then we're going into 2023, which should see first production. So the countdown clock is ticking a little bit to first production, and that's a really exciting and potentially value-creating process for our shareholders. So lots to do, but pleasingly so.
Good to see you this morning. Shaun, thanks very much.
Hey, thanks for your time, Andrew. I really appreciate it, as always.